got to the semifinals before losing to Lindsay Davenport. Starts with a double fault.
I was more impressed with that win yesterday, Barry, because Monica has not played many tournaments this year. Talked about the stress reactions at Scottsdale. She lost in semis to Shaughnessy. Indian Wells lost in the second round to Garbine, and then played a tournament over in Europe that I really don't think that she was prepared to play, and her foot was still bothering her, lost in her first match against De Los Rios in Madrid. But for most of 5 months, has only played that tournament in Stanford last week. So usually you don't come out in your second tournament back, have such consistency and rhythm and timing.
She actually played pretty well in that tournament in Stanford before losing to Lindsay Davenport. By her own admissions, she said she was not as match tough as she'd like to be and playing a notch better here. I thought clearly yesterday the best match she's played in a long time.
Well, one of the first things everybody noticed on the tour was that she is more fit than she was 5 months ago. Started with Lisa Reed, a new trainer, exactly 5 months ago, and she's lost a lot of weight and has gotten stronger and moving much better. And that's key for her game with the two hands on both sides.
Game service.
So Celis struggling a little bit with her service, but holding in the first game of the match, and we'll see if that sets a tone. So Monica Celis, one love.
First game.
Martina Hingis, now with mom back on the tour with her. Melanie Molitor hitting with Martina earlier today.
Melanie Molitor,
Martina Hingis to serve.
Mid-ranked player in Czechoslovakia in the 70s, and of course Martina Hingis named after Martina Navratilova, but she is out there as her coach, only coach that Hingis has ever had. And Martina Hingis gives her so much respect and so much credit. She's really, they really seem to have a great relationship. A couple of glitches along the way, a couple of times where they didn't part as coach, but she just didn't come to the tournaments. At Wimbledon a couple of years ago and a couple of tournaments this year. But
well, the first 2 points on Hingis' serve, Celis has done exactly what everybody has said she needs to do in this match, and that is just tee off on a short ball.
Incredible the way she timed that last shot.
15-30.
Out. Celis still did the right thing. She just played the ball, not the call. Anya Clark in the chair. Early chance for Monica Celis. She's played this second game extremely well.
And a second serve.
That's too good.
Second serve, 77 miles per hour, and Celis just climbs all over that second serve, an incredible angle. Monica Celis still has the best angles in the game. Look how she flips that wrist. Uses a lot of that right wrist to snap that ball.
Took advantage of every short ball in that game.
See that last ball from Hingis, smart shot. Monica Celis likes the shots right in her strike zone, about hip level to shoulder level. There she hit that ball right about head height.
Martina Hingis, now 20 years of age, still the number one player in the world. And will remain so after this tournament, although there will be some jockeying just beneath her.
Actually, Barry, Martina Hingis is 1,100 points ahead of the number two Capriati. And between two Capriati, Davenport, and Williams, there's only 118 points. So those three are just neck and neck.
That's a perfect shot from Hingis. And now she has three chances to break right back on the seller serve. Still two break points. Too wide, and a service break right back for Martina Hingis. We're back on serve. We're coming back. This is the semifinals of the Acura Classic. Back service breaks puts us back on serve. Hingis serving to even the first set at two. Take a look at the path to the semifinals for Martina Hingis. She beat Ostrolo in straight sets. Sugiyama, though, I think actually challenged her. She said that was a tough match.
It was a good match. Well contested. Sugiyama, very tough player from Japan, stands so close to the baseline. Very short, precise stroke. Hits the ball on the rise really early, a lot like Celis.
Hingis just talked about her forehand and that she's really pleased with the way she's been hitting her forehand. Very confident, needless to say, coming into this match. A lot of balls either right on or right over the line though.
A lot of balls that the players hesitated to play. Now you talk about her forehand, and Barry, I think that she needed to add some pace to that forehand, make it more of a weapon. The backhand hit with much more authority. And the serve, you know, that serve right there, 86 miles per hour first serve. She's usually in the 80s, mid-90s, but most of the top players are over 100 miles per hour for their first serve. And, of course, she's number one in the world, so I'm being very, very picky, but she's not won a Grand Slam title since the 99 Australian Open. It's about 2.5 years, and I think she's having a bit of trouble with the big hitters. Big hitters like Davenport, Williams, you know, they can get the free points on their big serve, and Martina Hingis doesn't have that luxury. She has to work the point around with a string of two or three shots to get her opponent out of balance.
Celis had to hit one-hander on the return of serve, hit it right on the line. Rip loose.
Watch Monica Celis hits the ball very flat, not much spin, so therefore it just shoots straight through the court.
That was that short ball again.
And it started with that return of serve. Second serve only 72 miles per hour and sat up and pushed Hingis about 3 feet behind the baseline. Defensive position.
Service breaks in a row now, and Celis has a one-break edge.
Well,
she had a hit. Was it two or three one-handers in that rally? Great win for her yesterday, as we said. Probably the best match that she's played since coming back to the tour.
Dominikovic in straight sets. Megan Shaughnessy, American, struggled in that first set. It was a tight 6-4 set, but best match 6-3, 6-3 over Capriati.
Remember Megan Shaughnessy just a week ago put Venus Williams out of the tournament, so that's a good win for her.
Footwork from Monica Seles right before she hits that shot. Just a lot of little steps to get right on balance. There she is, just always on balance. She goes to strike the ball. Lisa Reed actually emphasized yesterday that she continues to work on that. Monica's always had such terrific balance, gets those shoulders turned quickly, gets the knees bent, but you know, Lisa said that she continues to work on that, plyometrics, a lot of cardio, but nothing too pounding like running, because Monica's had problems with her feet the last two or three years.
She does seem to me, though, to be a little bit quicker along the baseline. I mean, a lot of those shots she has to hit one-handers to, or shots she wouldn't even get to before.
Right.
Boy, she yanked her all over the court. That's a vintage Seles point.
She has Hingis on a string out there, in control of the point. Look at her serve. Nice relaxed left hand. Down her back, stretches up nicely and gets a great wrist snap. Finish the serve inside that baseline with the body weight going forward. Great defensive play there from Hingis. At one point, she was 10 feet behind the baseline, got herself back into the point. And Monica Seles has talked about the fact that her serve was such a weapon, and she wanted to make it a weapon again, and has really worked on that coming into this tournament. Served great yesterday. Most of her first serves over 100 miles per hour.
So this now to try to consolidate the break. Boy, this match again starting out at a very high tempo.
You see Hingis with a big, deep breath there.
That's just a miss hit from Hingis. Seles holds. She has a broken hand. She leads 4-1, and we're coming back right after this. Seles 4-1 up now. Hingis to serve. Try to stay just a break down. One of the credos of tennis, know what you do well. And Monica Seles does.
I think my strengths are definitely my ground strokes. That's in terms of I can mix it up there. And I'm trying to improve my serve every turn because the girls are getting bigger and stronger and the game is going more towards that area, the 1-2-3 punch. And hopefully in the next couple of months, I'll have some improvements there.
You know, that's a sign of a champion. Still looking to, you know, that's what you have to do. But her service return has always been one of the best in the women's game, and still looking to improve it, take it to a new level.
That's too good. Right on a line from Martina Hingis. There's Lisa Reed, who we've been speaking of, Monica Seles' trainer, and her student doing a pretty darn good job.
Lisa said she's also working with her nutrition as well.
Just out. By about 30 feet. Well, weeknights at 11:30, it's The Last Word with Jim Rome. Romy telling it like it is on the Nightline of Sports Talk Shows. The Last Word with Jim Rome, weeknights at 11:30, right here on Fox Sports Net. So Seles to serve, a break in hand, 4-2. Again, that short ball, and Seles just punishes it.
Look how she leans into that shot so well. Just that whole body weight moving forward. Hit with such great authority. And again, because there's hardly any spin, it just hits that ground and continues to move forward at such a tremendous pace. Angus' shot has a little more topspin. It's not quite as penetrating, especially off that forehand side. An overrule from Anya Clark.
Yeah.
Gets that early, moves into the court diagonally, doesn't wait for her to come, wait for the ball to come to her at the baseline.
39.
Cuts the angle off and just drives it down the line.
Had her pulled off the court with that serve, too. So.
Whoa, great return serve.
This is a semifinal in the Acura Classic, and what a semifinal. The number one player in the world, Martina Hingis, number seven player in the world, and a number four seed here, Monica Seles. Seles coming off arguably her best win in probably a couple of years, beating Jennifer Capriati 6-3, 6-3 yesterday to get here, and picking up right where she left off. A break in hand in the first set. She leads 4-2, 30-15 in the seventh game.
40-15.
Hingis trying to force the issue there. Tough shot to go down the line. Change the direction of the ball.
Well, out. Seles holds 5-2. So Monica Seles has not apparently missed a beat. And once again, Martina Hingis playing pretty well, too. Welcome back. Martina Hingis now to serve to stay in this first set. Once again, a very well-played match on both players' parts.
Not sure Hingis would agree with you there, but she's made a few more mistakes than she usually does, but maybe we need to give more credit to Monica Seles for taking Hingis out of her rhythm.
Oof. She didn't get a call, and then she just kind of punched the ball back, and it was out.
That's so close. I can't tell.
Anya Clark is never going to overrule on the sideline on the other side.
15.
Yeah, she looked out, didn't she?
Did.
But even so, isn't the rule you got to play the ball, right?
That's exactly right. That was a lazy shot right there for Martina Hingis. Just one big loping step to get ready for that forehand.
Brilliantly. That's as good as you could hit that shot.
Such incredible finesse.
30.
Number one player in the world. Soft, soft hands. Just right underneath the ball. Really loose grip there.
Came at an important point, too.
Hingis was in trouble right from the get-go. Second serve, shorter than it should have been, and 77 miles per hour. Seles all over, and it gives her a set point.
And she's got her down to a second serve again here.
Seles inside the baseline, ready to go for it.
Pulled that one wide, knew it immediately.
And that's the decision as a player. Do I go for it big time and go near the line, or just hard up the middle? Because I may be a little bit tighter on this point as Monica Seles. It's a great timing. Off the baseline, that ball was rising up towards her face and just knocks it off for a second set point.
Just impeccable. Good serve from Hingis.
Out. Deuce.
is wide.
Edmondos Hingis.
So now Hingis with a point to hold. 4-3-5 first set.
Hingis pulled her head down a bit. Stay up. Keep that head up. Snap that wrist. To move on over that net.
And she'll take it.
She will. Fights off two set points. She's still in the set. Casellas with 9 grand slams. Hingis with 5. Jennifer Capriati with 2. The first 2 this year. The Australian Open and the French Open. Mary Pierce with 2 French Opens. Casellas has won 4 Australian, 3 French, and 2 U.S. Open. Has been to the finals of Wimbledon once, where she lost to Steffi Graf. Baseline, hits it about a foot earlier than most of the players would, so Hingis just doesn't have enough time to react. Look at that footwork, constantly adjusting. Look how she stays down. Monica just always in that crouch position.
Second of the match.
Rare double fall. We don't see her miss hit it that badly very often.
Yeah, she double falled in actually the first 2 serves of the game, of the match, I should say. Well, she had it that time.
That one, she actually didn't get up off the baseline enough, kind of had to reach for that ball.
Little opening now for Martina Hingis at 30-all. Not sure Martina Hingis gets enough credit for being a battler, and she certainly is. There have been moments where she's been in the spotlight where it hasn't been so, but...
Actually, I think she gets a lot of credit for that. That's one of her big weapons, that she battles, and also the fact that she can change her game around in a certain situation, has the capability to go to different games, loop the ball, start to serve and volley.
I think, though, there's that image of the loss to Steffi Graf at Paris that people have a tendency to remember instead of all the other times she's bounced back.
Ooh. Just incredible. A couple of great stabs from Hingis. Smart play from Casellas, seeing that Hingis is so far behind the baseline. Look at, she takes that right underneath the ball. Still gets down low for that drop shot.
His first serve has deserted her for the moment. And again, that big sitter. And Casellas punished it, and he brings it a set point. Third set point. 9 winners off the forehand side now for Monica Casellas.
Hingis thinking she's going to give herself a little more time to get back to the center, loop this ball up, but Monica has nothing. She wants to wait for that shot. Moves in off that baseline, drives it. Ooh.
Yes!
She is moving so much better.
That was a big-time point by Monica Casellas to win this first set 6-3.
Well, Sally's hitting on the ground strokes just as she used to, but she just seems so much more confident in her footwork than she was. We'll be back.
We have to up the level of her game just a bit. Go up a notch. Try something different. Try those drop shots. Get Monica Seles out of that rhythm. Mix in a few slices, especially try to slice the ball down to Seles' forehand. It's tough to do when you have to hit a second serve, and it's just crunched in the corner.
She's just punishing every short ball and every sitter that Hingis hits.
Hingis with 62% of her first serves in. Which is a decent percentage, Barry, but at 62%, you need to be getting a lot of power on that first serve. Now, if you're only hitting first serves in the 80s and the low 90s, you should be up around 75%. Ooh, just wide.
Wide enough that it brings 15-14. To a couple of break points for Monica Seles to start this second set. What a way to start the set that would be for her.
Hingis looks over towards her mom and says, what can I do? Yes. She's looking a little frustrated.
Who is this woman? I haven't seen her in seven times. And it must be said, while she's beaten Seles seven in a row, Seles has not really been Seles for the last couple of years.
You mean like
I mean, she's had one injury or another.
Right. Well, she hasn't been Seles the way that she dominated the game since she was stabbed in 93.
That's true. Seles with the break in the first game of the second set. She won the first set 6-3. It's got to please everybody around her. And right now, let's go to Patrick, who is with one of the person who's around her more than anybody else. Patrick?
Yes, it's obvious that Monica Seles has taken a strong effort in getting into better shape. Big part of that is her trainer, Lisa Reed. Lisa, since you joined Monica, what part have you been working on to get her in better shape?
Just overall fitness, strength and conditioning, balance, you know, speed, everything, explosiveness, everything, but, you know, everything with the game, but, you know, all aspects of strength and conditioning.
Also, what about her nutrition? Have you been doing something with that?
Yes. She's definitely gotten leaner, and we have goals, and she's doing a great job. She's awesome.
Any weight training?
Yes. Yes, strength conditioning. And the weights in the weight room, going out of hard, explosiveness, working everything, a little plyometrics, a little bit, everything.
Lisa, thank you very much. Back to you, Barry.
Okay, thanks, Patrick. And well, it's all paying off here in this tournament, it seems, doesn't it?
And, you know, Barry, I think it's really smart of Monica to bring Lisa Reed with her on the tour, have her there day in and day out. You know, Monica's won something like $13 million in prize money, umpteen million in endorsements. She can afford it, so it's good to have that person who's going to help you get discipline on something that's so crucial to her game.
There's that sharp angle from Hingis.
I've been saying for a couple of years now, Monica got as high as number three or four in the last couple of years and was in no way in the same good shape as the rest of the players in the top 10 were. So I kept saying if Monica could only get in that great shape, she might make it back to number one again. Monica was ranked number one in the world 178 weeks. Boy, did she get up to that short ball quickly. Talk about explosiveness, quick first step. Just looks extremely hungry to go after that ball. Puts everything into every single shot. Just no reprieve for her opponents. Hits hard off the backhand, off the forehand, off the serve, off the return.
And it is, just to emphasize your point.
Playing incredibly focused.
She really is. She is in an absolute zone right now. Here are the numbers in the first set. 13 winners from Seles, mostly off the forehand side.
At two of four break opportunities.
Again.
And that's the difference right there, is that she's getting to that shot and then able to get there early enough that she's able to do something with it.
That's the 10th winner off the forehand side for Monica Seles.
Hold!
And a double fault brings us to love 30. First double fault from Hingis, but right now, Hingis is going to have to find something to change the tenor of this match. Death touch.
I mean, coming in and hitting that ball out of the air, she hit it so low. This is not an easy shot to come up with. And then watch this volley. Great touch. You know, Hingis is so good at the net. All that doubles really has paid off, and she has so much talent.
Again, a big sitter, and Seles just tees off.
What she's lacking in her game right now, Barry, is the power. The power that the top players have from that serve especially.
She being Hingis.
Hingis.
So break point for two breaks and a set up.
Better second serve. Nice and deep. That depth on the serve is just as crucial as the power, and the placement was good. Big game here for Hingis. Can't be go down two breaks in the second.
She got there. Couldn't quite bunt it in, though. Sherry, all match time. Just under 40 minutes thus far. We played a set and two games. That time off the backhand side.
Seles with just too much time to get set up and get on balance for the backhand. Key with Seles, as with Davenport, you just can't let them set up because they're so lethal off both the forehand and the backhand, and go for each shot almost every single time. Tina Hingis, when I say that, Hingis, once in a while you'll see a shot where she'll loop it back in and it gives you a bit of a reprieve. With Seles, every single shot she's trying to end the point. Even with Venus Williams, once in a while we'll loop a shot in, or Serena.
Cross court off the second serve.
Looks like working on that return's paying off. She always has such a great return, but Mike Sell, who Seles is working with, just been hitting her a ton of serves so that Seles can get the rhythm on the return.
Just didn't miss it that time.
Mike Sell, who Monica started working with just this week, just got done with playing with the Delaware Smash in team tennis this past Sunday. So a new trainer, new workout partner.
It's all working just fine. Good second serve from Hingis. And she holds. So it wasn't easy, but Martina Hingis holds. We are at the legendary La Costa Resort and Spa, and we've got a lot more tennis to come. So don't go away. We're coming back. Welcome back. Barry Tompkins, Tracy Austin, Patrick O'Neill. Acura Classic semifinal. Number one and number seven, Monica Seles and Martina Hingis. And Seles won the first set 6-3. She has a break in hand in the second set to serve for 3-1.
Oh, Monica's punishing the ball. And yesterday in her press conference after she beat Capriati, Monica did mention, you know, she knew that she was playing at another level in an extra gear, and she was just waiting for the wheels to come off and not play as well, and never did.
I can tell she's made a believer out of you.
Because, you know, in the last couple of years, she's had sets where she played this level, but not as often as before where she stringed the whole match together.
I saw her last week at the Bank of the West, and you could kind of see it coming. She didn't quite have it all together, but this week she does.
Last time that Monica Seles beat Martina Hingis was 8 matches ago, and that was the Canadian Open, 1998.
She had Hingis on the defense that entire point.
Well, actually, one shot, Hingis had a high ball, a high lob, but she could have done more with if he hit that forehand out of the air. She hit it up the line, and up the middle of the court. Let Seles back in the point, and then Seles took over. Hingis is going to have to take a few more risks. Can't out-rally Monica Seles out there today. Try to get more depth, better angles, add some pace.
It's just too good. I mean, it's just a very well-constructed point from Seles, and your point is so well taken. I mean, she hits every shot as though she intends it to be a winner.
Seles leads 3-2.
Take a moment to take a look at the Yonex fastest serves and the women's game getting up there right now. Venus Williams, of course, atop the heap. But she's got a lot of company.
Jennifer Capriati, 113. Barbara Schett, 110. Lindsay Davenport, 108. Not a surprise that Venus is at the top. Shot there from Martina Hingis. Didn't go for the power, but went for the placement. And that's what she has to try to do. Try to widen the court for Monica Seles. Get her on the move so she doesn't have time to get set up. Of course, that's a tall order because Hingis doing all the running.
Again, taking that ball so early.
I got to give Hingis credit, though. Trying to serve and volley. Trying to change it up. Try something new. Monica Seles just seeing the ball so early on that return of serve. Reminds me a lot of Andre Agassi when she returns. They get that split step, that body weight going forward, the hands out in front, not a big backswing.
Dropped in.
Even her miss hits are going in.
I was just going to say, it's not exactly the way she wanted it, but she'll take it.
Good stretch there. Hingis tries to wrong foot Seles. Good anticipation from Seles.
Try to play a really severe angle. We're watching an Acura Classic semifinal match, and what a match it's been. The number one player in the world and the number one seed here, Martina Hingis, against the number seven seed, Monica Seles. And Seles wins the first set 6-3. She has a break up in this set. Reduce in the fifth game of the second set. And Hingis coming in under that defensive shot and just putting it away.
Crucial game here for Hingis to stay in this match.
Ha!
wins and continues to be down just a break.
Straight set, so she's really turning this around today.
In one of those matches, she double bageled Monica Seles, the only match ever that Seles has lost Love and Love.
That was at the Ericsson Open last year.
Well, it went the other way earlier.
15-9.
Seles hit that forehand incredibly late. But still got the net cord.
Well, tried to play a severe angle again and hit it wide. So Inges dodged a bullet there.
And that's what Seles has to continue to do. That's when she plays her best tennis, is when she goes for her shots, goes for the depth, the angles, and the power. Cannot play tentative tennis.
And again, hit it out. So all of a sudden, all those balls that were hitting the lines are not quite there. And a little bit of an opportunity here, perhaps, for Monica, for Martina Hingis. That just froze it.
It was a good serve, but not enough on that return. This loose arm bends the knees and then moves on up into that serve. That Hingis forehand, again, I'm being picky, is not as powerful, not as strong as the backhand.
Oh, Seles again, twice in this game, has tried to do a little bit too much.
That shot is actually tougher than it looked, because she was trying to change the direction of the ball, and she had to run in there, get her body turned around, and hit that ball below the level of her net, of the net, with two hands.
And right now, probably the most pivotal point of the match. Break point chance for Hingis to get the second set even. Third double fault. None could come at a worse time for Monica Seles than that one. We're back on serve here in the second set. And suddenly, what seemed to be just a real streak for Monica Seles has, if not come to a grinding halt, that has at least hit a pothole.
A little brighter now for Martina Hingis. Had not broken Seles since the third game of the first set.
Now, it hasn't been really easy for Hingis in her service games either.
Four out of the seven times that she served, gone to deuce. She's been broken three times in this match.
Seles snaps that one right up the line.
Just a great angle sets up this shot. Plenty of time to get ready.
That was a great first serve from Hingis, and Seles just played herself back into the point.
Remember, Monica Seles is with the wind at her back just a bit now. So Martina Hingis has to play against the wind. It's going to add more weight to the Seles ground strokes.
Goes long.
15-30. 71 mile per hour second serve. That's not going to cut it.
Came back a lot faster than that, didn't it?
15-40.
And sitting up. Look where she is, about 3 feet inside that baseline.
Two break points to get the break back here in the seventh game. Well, that looked awfully good.
double fault to get the break right back. Well, the second double fault, no question she was thinking about that serve off the tee. Looked pretty good. Miss hit, and of course, Monica Seles just taking no prisoners.
But look where that ball bounced, right at the service line. Got to get the ball about 3 feet from the baseline in order to hang in there in the backcourt with Monica Seles. The depth is crucial, and Hingis usually with great depth.
I thought she framed that shot maybe a little bit.
Just
out.
15-0.
Very close on errors. Hingis with 14, Seles with 15. But in the winner's department, Monica Seles with 27 and Hingis with only 16. So that's the difference in the match. Monica's deciding the pace of this match and doing a good job of it, staying in charge.
Too fine with it, and it wouldn't happen.
13-15.
Sherry on match time now shows exactly 1 hour of play between these two.
Monica Seles has 18 winners on that forehand side. Martina Hingis only one.
Big difference. How's that for an astute comment?
Well, it's not a surprise because, you know, I've talked about Hingis having that better backhand, and really like to see more racket head speed on Hingis's forehand.
Oh, yeah. Kind of going the wrong direction, held the ball long enough, gives her two breaks for a 5-3 lead.
Kind of going in the wrong direction. She's done that a lot today.
And let me correct myself quickly. Of course, it's not a break point chance because she's serving.
She's got Hingis rolling and running. She's so in control.
Hingis not going quietly, though.
14-13.
Melanie Molitor.
Three for Monica Seles. On Thursday on Fox Sports Net, don't miss first round coverage of the Buick Open. See who jumped out to the early lead in one of the most prestigious midseason events on the PGA Tour. Coverage beginning Thursday at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific, right here on Fox Sports Net. So Henry's now serving to stay in the match.
That last point of that last game, very, very impressive from Monica Seles. On the dead run, that ball actually behind her on the backhand side and came up with a pure winner. That's something that you'll also see from a Lindsay Davenport, from the Williams sisters. They look like they're in a huge predicament, and they could come up with an offensive winner.
With a rather easy service game thus far, the easiest one she's had.
Good second serve, Hingis
got a couple of good second serves to hold, but she holds it love. Celis will serve for the match when we come back after this. Doubles after the conclusion of this match. Which could be why he's here.
I bet he's interested just to check out this match as well with the U.S. Open about 3 weeks away. Maybe pick up a tip or two on some strategy.
Double fault for Monica Seles to start this service game that would give her the match if she holds. Fourth double fault.
One thing to get here, it's another to close the match out.
Yep.
Ooh, Monica caught a big break right there. And then Hingis thought that ball was long, and she might have had a case.
Yeah, I agree.
It was out.
That one was out.
Well, now Monica Seles is going to have to dig down a little bit here. I love the idea that if she gets broken here to get back on serve, almost anything could happen in this match.
Usually you talk about trouble with closing out with rookies, people that are just coming up, not nine-time Grand Slam champions. But this would be a huge win for Seles right here. Not the right shot for Martina Hingis to try. When you go up the line with that backhand, it's got to be a winner or a near winner because you're leaving that whole cross court open. Boy, that's a Grand Canyon size shot that Seles can hit for a winner.
From Martina Hingis brings us to 30-all.
30-all.
Seles' first serve has not been very effective in this service game.
And really, for Martina Hingis, that was a bad error. You know, 83 mile per hour second serve, and she usually gets all those in the court. That big serve sets up a match point.
And the crowd very much behind Monica Seles. They have been all week.
40-30.
Sentimental favorite.
Everywhere she goes.
Yeah, she is. And with good reason. Second serve, match point. It's out. That's it. Seles through to the final. 6-3, 6-4 over the number one in the world.
Another incredible day for Monica Seles. Played well in the first set and continued that through the second set. Stayed